I clicked on it once. Google News story, I clicked on it once.
What, David?
Some article like a year ago about a lady teacher who a young right?
Mm-hmm.
It's curiosity. I can't help myself. Now, there's a new story in my Google News feed about once a month of some lady teacher boy.
Yeah, it's disgusting. They have a problem. They belong in the same special hell as priests.
Is it like a Dante's Inferno where like the punishment fits the crime?
Shit, I don't know. I'm not the devil. I don't know what he does. He probably like does them in the butt. And it's like, ow, that's hot. You know, because the devil's like on fire.
Yeah, I get it. It's worse than normal. Because the devil's made of fire.
Exactly. I don't think Dante actually went to hell.
So you're saying that you can't get biblical philosophy from stories?
Only from
because
Constantine.
I know someone that has gotten all of their biblical philosophy from stories.
That's how I know.
You know, because if Keanu Reeves is in it,
yeah,
then it must be biblically accurate.
That's how I teach my kids.
Jesus Christ Superstar. Mm-hmm. They're like singing like West Side Story.
Huh? I love that movie, so shut your face.
I think it's good too.
I love it.
I think it's really good.
Makes me feel bad for Judas though.
So before we get into this, you have no explanation. Makes me feel bad for Judas.
Hey, I don't think he should. They already knew. Does that constitute him as a demon? No.
Does that constitute him as a demon?
That's what they say. That's what he says. He's there. If Judas is there, then so should everybody who does everything bad.
I believe that is the point of hell. I believe you nailed it. Your first theologically, biblologically correct statement from someone that loses at children's Bible trivia on the regular.
I do.
All right, so Kira, this is a video you've been wanting to shoot for a while.
Oh, yay.
Are you excited about this?
I'm always excited about shooting film. This is exactly how I want to spend my days. For the people. Look what you've done to me.
Join our Patreon for reluctant content just like this.
You assholes.
My name is David, this is Kira, and welcome to thewhiskeychannel.com. Mm-hmm. And today, we're shooting a video that Kira has wanted to shoot for a while.
Yes.
Today's video is something that Kira has had on her wish list for a while. Very excited about it. Matter of fact, in previous weeks, she attempted midstream to turn other videos into this video.
Yeah, it's just crazy. It's like my mind wants to do this video.
Like my mind is telling me no.
But my body.
My body's telling me yes.
All right, what is it, stupid David?
As I'm known at home.
Mm-hmm.
This is five bottles and or brands we've changed our minds on.
Yeah, because we're human and we can have our own experiences and change our minds. Like, the first time I went down a water slide, I effing hated it. Okay, because the guy didn't tell me when to go down, so I just went down, and it was going super duper fast speed, because you can adjust the speeds back then, and I almost drowned. So I decided I hate water slides, but then I went on one another time, and I had fun.
Is there a stigma that you can't change your whiskey opinion, or is that something that we're just weird about?
I think it's only us. I think people in this world decide that you have to have one opinion and one opinion only, and you can never falter from that opinion unless you are a or a liar or a lawyer.
Abramowitz! Your great grandmother's last name was Abramowitz. I found it on an ancestry website. That makes you a dirty liar because you are Jewish. Okay, that came out kind of bad. I'm not disgusted by the Jewish part. It's the lying part that I was talking about. This dirty liar is a Jewish man.
Is it okay to change your mind? Like, if you taste a whiskey once, you say some words about it. Is it okay to change your mind upon a second sip?
I think that it is. I do.
I think so too.
Especially if the whiskey has just recently been opened, so you get the bottleneck pour, which isn't a real thing, y'all out there. No, it isn't.
It's a real thing.
Because you have to let it breathe. Is that called a bottleneck? No. Maybe you let it breathe when it was down here and tastes better. Okay? So calm your jets, cool your boats, and chill out.
Speaking of jets, how do you feel about ranch?
F you. It's almost gone. I need more things to put my ranch in.
Do you?
Yeah.
You live a tough life.
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow's dinner is going to be a ranch wrap.
Join our Patreon to give Kira more things to put ranch on.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, and by the way, today's video is sponsored by thewhiskeychannel.com. Thewhiskeychannel.com is your place to go and get single barrel picks occasionally. Mm-hmm. Laughs every so often.
Friends. And
fantasy football during several months once a year.
Fantasies in general.
Mash Madness, a tournament you don't get to participate on except in bracket form.
Music.
Sometimes music.
Do it. Owe yourself a little gratitude. Is that what they say?
No.
Is that a sentence?
Five bottles we've changed our minds on. Kira, are you ready for one? Are you excited about this?
I am so excited.
All right, Kira, I'm going to bring out a little humdinger to get us started. Ready?
Oh, gosh, that's disgusting.
I'm sorry, what?
The cold sores.
Those are called humdingers?
I don't know. I think it's a cold sore problem.
Like, bringing out a little hepatitis C just to get us started. Bringing out something that Kira swore up and down she enjoyed but has changed her mind on it since. Mm-hmm. Barstown Fusion number 4. Go ahead, Kira, pour yourself
number
some of that.
Number 4. I was like, I love this. I think I was a couple pours in for the night playing video games, not realizing. And I can't even open it.
Now, from the start, and I am not good at whiskey, I am the world's worst whiskey taker, I did not like Barstown Fusion 4, but what I'll throw in my glass over here is a whiskey that's very similar that I have changed my mind on. Originally, I thought I liked Barstown Fusion 3 and 5, and I no longer like them. This is number 3.
Yes. So, Barstown Fusion sucks, just to let you all know. Now, save your money.
What do you remember about Barstown Fusion 4?
So I do remember thinking that this was like a nice spicy treat, like a candy spiced treat. And then I tasted it again and it's really gross. It's like moldy, grassy, rotten apple core without the good apple sweetness to it. Just like the seeds.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, gross. No nosy notes on 4. She's right in.
Yikes. Ooh, shush, shush, shush. It's really bad. It's like urine-soaked barrel oak. Yeah, with a little bit of fire. It's been on fire because of the char, probably.
So 3 is not as bad as I remember it being.
Now it's like getting grosser.
But you know what's weird about the fusions?
Mm.
It's not bad until you're like 45 seconds into a pour. And then something funky happens.
Yeah.
It just sort of goes to a gross place.
Mine turns into like pencil lead, almost. In a bad way.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Nope. Well, how am I going to finish this?
I don't know if the camera's even going to catch this, but I'm going to dump it out.
Ooh. Sounds like someone just took a pee-pees.
It's super gross.
The pee-pee's a water park!
I've just finished some tests. The water in your park is now 98% pee.
Yes, so what's the problem?
Pee-pee, you know that acceptable pee levels in any water park is 83%.
Bottle number 2, I liked it right away. Kira did not like it right away, and then her opinion changed over the first couple of weeks, and I was forbidden from drinking it again.
Mm.
It is Nulu bourbon whiskey, finished in apple brandy barrels. It is actually an ADHD single barrel pick. Kira, do you want to talk about your experience with
this? Sure. So, I was so excited. It's Nulu. I friggin' love Nulu. I also friggin' love Matt. But this, my initial tasting note, was not fun. I did not have a fun time. I was like, where's the apple? Where's the goodness? I don't want it. So I said, here, David, you can have it. And then, I was watching TV, you know, a couple weeks later. And I just grabbed a random bottle because I'm watching, you know, TV like, someone's getting killed. You can't take your eyes off the screen. So I just grabbed a bottle, poured it, drank it. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. And it's this. And no one else can have it in the house except for me. This is only mine. You better not.
I don't even get to taste it right now, so.
Like a wooden carameled apple, but also with like a candy. So like the caramel, but that's the red caramel. A candy apple, not a caramel apple, but a candy one.
A candy apple.
Yes. Someone doesn't go to the fair. I'm getting a little bit of like a cotton candy right in here. Cotton candy mixed with some apple, that sucker, that's caramel apple. The inside apple, not the caramel.
The one you get at the oil change place.
Green, no, they give me shitty dum-dums.
I wonder why.
Yeah, but like super tart green apple. I freaking love it. This is amazing.
So moving on to bottle number three that we have changed our minds on. We started with something that went kind of sour, went to something that we ended up liking. Mm-hmm. Let's go to something that Kira says that she never likes, but always places well in a blind whenever she does it. New Riff Single Barrel. Mm-hmm. Kira, how do you feel about this bottle?
No, I'm not drinking it. I don't like it.
You know, in blinds, you tend to like it. So why is that, Kira? Why do you not like it in person when you see the bottle, but you do like it in blinds?
Because I don't get the hype about New Riff. I don't think it's that great. It doesn't have anything new to offer. I don't know.
Is that why you don't like it? Because it doesn't offer anything new and there's new in the name? Unlike every other whiskey company that says old?
Yes. So if you're going to call yourself new, bring something new to the table.
This is the story I heard about New Riff. None of them had previously been in like the whiskey making business prior to this.
Oh, so they were real shitty at it.
Well, it also means that they were all new to it and they brought something new, which you just critiqued them for not doing.
Oh, they didn't bring anything new. It was new to them because they don't know anything. And then they're like, it's Riff because we like to play guitar. Like a riff on a guitar. Really? That's like me calling my bottle I'm going to make like a new TV watching distillery. New murder mystery solving distillery.
Is it?
New puzzle putting together distillery.
To me, it's sort of clove, vanilla. Mm. It's not off-putting in any way. I'm really confused why you don't like it. Give it a try. It's not gonna knock your socks off, but it's an affordable bottle. It's 112.5. This one is.
Is it affordable? How much is it?
Like 50 bucks.
I'd rather buy Evan Williams Bottle Bond.
I'm not saying that it's the best $50 pour ever, but I don't think it's bad. What do you make of that?
It's not that bad.
Wait, can you? There's a microphone here. A microphone there and a camera there. Can you say it closer to one of...
It's not that bad, but hold on a second. I just drank the Nulu Apple Brandy finish and that, and this, for some reason, brought out way more apple tartness.
Moving on to bottle number four. We've changed our minds on, Kira, is sweaty. That's how much New Riff is getting your hot under the collar. Bottle number four. Kira, we're going to go to one that we... I don't know if we need to eat crow on it, because I think we had a tainted bottle.
Oh.
We cleared the shelves. We cleared A shelf. When B521, Elijah Craig Barrel Proof came out, we opened up a bottle. Everybody was ranting, raving about it. We tasted it and said, what on God's green earth?
Cocaine is everyone smoking out there.
Can you smoke cocaine?
I have no idea.
Well, that is a very astute question. What cocaine are they smoking? We use some for giveaways, charity giveaways, regular old Patreon giveaways, whatever. Yep. Kept one back so that we could rip on it at a further date. Opened it up recently in an all Elijah Craig Barrel Proof blind and were stunned that we gave any of those away because the second bottle we opened was good.
Yeah, so if you're a patron of ours, you will get our shitty whiskey that we don't like.
No, people were saying like, hey, if you don't like it, because they knew we had multiple bottles, if you don't like it, give us whatever. Or hey, if you don't like it, I'll take it. Or hey, donate it to my charity drive, whatever. And we were like, yeah, it's not that good. We'll donate. Go ahead.
I think I remember it being really hot and less tasty than anything.
This one does drink all of 118 proof. This is not one of those Elijah Craig Barrel Proofs that drinks under its punching weight. It definitely drinks up there a bit of that heat and that ethanol. But it's solid. Not my favorite Elijah Craig Barrel Proof ever, but it's solid.
It's not too bad. So it smells a little florally, but then when I'm drinking it, it's really, I don't know, a ton of caramel and oak.
Well, it's just like your prototypical bourbon profile, yeah. Right? Like like brown sugar, caramel, vanilla, a lot of burnt toasty oak in there.
Toasty, I get black pepper.
Yes.
So
it's right down the middle. It's solid. I think I'd never gotten a tainted bottle before.
Mm-hmm.
I think we got a tainted bottle. That first one was gross as H.
It didn't taste like that at all. It tasted like fire. Like not fireball, but
it was
burnt fire.
And there was something wrong with it beyond even being like burnt fire extra hot. There was something that like we were trying to stomach it as a mixer and it was a problem as a mixer.
It tasted like this.
Ooh.
Fusion 4. It was gross. It's good now.
So speaking of something that a little surprise bottle for you for number 5, because I believe we've changed our minds on it.
Okay.
What are your thoughts on Woodford Reserve Rye Jonah store pick, which you said was great in the store?
Yes.
We brought it back and we adjusted the scale on the video we did, said, all right, on any old whiskey or rye, it's this. But for Woodford, it's this. We put its own special scale in there. What do you recall?
I don't recall that video at all. I do remember. I don't watch our videos. No, in the store, what do we call him? The buyer?
The connoisseur.
And he seduced me with something first. I think it was Jack Daniels, their Jack Daniels pick.
Sure.
And gave me this, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so good. He warmed me up first.
He did. He bamboozled you.
Yeah, he did. It was a little bit of foreplay happening. And then I got this, I was like, yeah, that's great. And then I left, and I was like, wait, was it? What just happened? Because when I brought it home, you were like, why did you buy this? And I said, it's so good, David, you gotta try it.
It was an assault on our integrity. We have talked about Woodford Reserve a number of times. About what they do with those copper triple pot still, whatever it is they do, double spot still, whatever it is that makes them really sort of this offshoot of Brown-Forman, we just don't tend to like it.
Mm-mm. And I still, I get, so there's a ton of rye. I love that part.
Sure.
But you're getting this weird, no oak, or the oak's gone bad. It's pretty not fun and it's not refreshing. It's really bland. I don't know. All I'm getting is just a peppermint wintergreen taste, which is fine for a rye, but you would think with a Woodford Reserve, there should be a little bit more going.
I think it's just a really, really average rye. And I'll say this, I say average and then immediately what comes to mind, Wild Turkey 101 rye, Old Forester rye, those kick this thing's ass.
Yeah.
So it's got to be below average. I don't think it's as off-putting as any other Woodford product that we've had.
Mm-hmm.
But when you think that this thing is like $35, $40 and you can go out and get stellar ryes, Old Forester rye, Wild Turkey 101 rye, this extreme value down in that price range, this doesn't even come close to that.
Not at all. It's like Evan Williams, their first try ever.
From the 1700s. All right, so that's 5 bottles we've changed our minds on. Mm-hmm. There are 5 more to come. Hopefully, we don't piss too many people off.
Yeah, sorry about it, but you can change your mind. You like something, you don't. You do like something, then you don't like it. Or, you know, you can do whatever, all right? Because you're a person, and it's all right to change your mind.
Like, comment, subscribe if you're a person. Although I know we have a lot of sex bots that are also liking, commenting, and subscribing because we've had to block all their comments. So I actually have some pre-written questions for you.
Fucking A.
For this one.
Why?
Well, just to get the juices flowing.
Tell me which side my hair looks best on. This side? Or this side? What do you like better?
That side? Yeah, that side.
Why?
I didn't know this would be a quiz. Sorry, I have sushi burps real bad right now.
Yeah, I know. You've been having them all day.
Why didn't you say anything?
You
know what's the worst is sushi farts.
I've never had a sushi fart before.
I have never eaten sushi and not gotten sushi farts.
Then you might have a reaction to fish. No wonder.
I was gonna say. That brings all new legitimacy.
Do I have lipstick on my teeth?
No, but why are you tasting your finger?
See, that's from like lipstick doesn't get on.
Actually, you do have lipstick on your teeth, let me see. Yeah, you have a little bit on like one of those lower teeth. I saw it down there.
I have sushi in my teeth.
Ah, I thought it was lipstick.
Oh. Well, just don't zoom in on my teeth.
Well, you know that's 100% gonna happen.
David, don't. Is it really? You're such a mean person.
Such a mean person. Don't show everyone the sushi in my tea. Why are we making sex noises already?
Hey, oh yeah!
I do sound older during sex, by the way.
Oh, that was me.
Oh, I thought it was me.
You're just like, I'm gonna go fast.
I was like, what is that, like a little, like a 10-year-old? Is that like
ew, David!
That boy from That's My Boy? The guy that banged his teacher? What do you think? Okay, so...
try it. Do a sip of this and then a sip of that. That might be my new Blend Mageddon.
Really?
Uh-huh. Blend a Mageddon. Blend... blend your hearts out.
So. You realize I'm not allowed to drink that, right?
Well, you could do it this one.
Thank you for giving me...
I won't tell the other Kira's brain.
Giving me so much to drink. There's... you're a generous, generous, large-handed woman, and I appreciate that. That's very good.
Yes.
Wow. Apple, aged, you know, nobody cares. All right.
Get that little hit.
Nobody cares what I say.